Hello everyone, this is Rick with CyberMedics, and we're here today to talk about Gmail, specifically how to create a Gmail account. So we'll go over here to create an account, and we're setting up this account to try to do an email recovery for one of our subscribers. They have lost their password and they're logged into one of their devices, but they don't have any other devices that they're logged into. So they want to try to reset the password. So I thought we would go in here first and create an account for them and use this as a test account to run through the scenario of being able to recover an account that you are logged into a device, but you've lost the password. We'll confirm that password. And select next. We will not enter a phone number. Do not recommend entering a phone number for your account recovery. Now, a recovery email address, highly recommend a recovery email address. I think they may force you to put in this information. I'm not sure. Let's find out. It's been so long since I created. Yes, they are going to ask you to fill this out. Okay. So why we ask for this information, to keep your account secure. Have age requirements. That's why they want the birth date. All right. So come here, select next. Privacy terms. You have no privacy with Gmail. All right. So now you have your Gmail account all set up. We'll go over a couple things here just real quick. And setting up an account, manage your Gmail account over here on security. I'm not going to go into a lot of detail on this because we've covered it in so many other videos. I have a link above to additional information about securing your Gmail account, but just quickly wanted to go into this security section. Two-step verification is off. You definitely want to turn that on. When you go to turn that on, it's going to give you some options. It's going to require your password again. Don't want to do the phone number. No. Show more options. Here's what you want to do. So now you can come down here and you can say select a security key or a Google prompt. Security key is a hardware physical key that plugs into the side of your device. YubiKey is a well-known manufacturer of these. There are other manufacturers also. A Google prompt is something that will be sent to one of your devices that is already logged into your account to confirm logging in on the account. I always advocate adding authentication methods in addition to your password. Down here where it says show more options, unless you have a second factor authentication method added, you won't be able to get backup codes for your account. So let's just go ahead and do the security key. So put in your password here. Click next. Have a security key? Yes, we have a hardware security key. We have it plugged into the machine. You'll get two prompts. So we are going to have to go through this because there's something important I just want to share with you. When you're setting up an account, we have to physically touch the key. I'm going through this rather quickly because we've covered it in detail in other videos. All right, so now that we've set up a key, we have a hardware security key. This gives you access to some things that are extremely important. One of them is backup codes, okay? So I'm not worried about showing these because we're going to take this off of here in a little bit anyway. These backup codes are extremely important, because if you lost your password, you lost your hardware security key, if you had no other method, you can use these codes. They're one time. Now, they're one time codes. Once you use it, you can't use the code again. But you could put these on a piece of paper, put it in a safe deposit box, put it in your fire safe at your house, download it electronically, and store it on an encrypted file. However you want to secure these, they should be secured and be part of your account recovery methods that you should use. We'll go back here. The other thing is that once you've added a second factor authentication, two-step verification, you can also use the Authenticator app. And that is something you would download from the Google Play Store or iOS Store. You download that application, and what happens is when you log into your account, that application gets a prompt to confirm that you are who you are to log into your account. So it's another layer. And to set that authenticator up, they provide you a QR code. And once you've downloaded the app to your phone, you take and point the camera of your phone to this QR code, you scan it, and then the account and the phone are linked together. So if you can't scan it, you do this, and now it gives you this key. This is a software security key that is used to validate the account. This key is also extremely important and should be backed up along with your backup codes. The reason is, let's say you lost your Authenticator app on your telephone because you lost the phone became damaged, whatever. As long as you have this security key, the software security key, you can take that and manually add another Authenticator app and have access back into your account. But if you don't record this key through the process of authenticating, then you're going to be lost. I mean, your Authenticator app will not be able to be used to get access to your account. So we'll cancel out of this because we're not going through that process. We've got videos here linked above to show you how to do that. So we're not going to set up the Authenticator app. I just wanted to kind of go through these because if you're setting up a new account, so backup codes, we covered that. Authenticator app, we covered that. So I just added this phone to the account. So now that is something else you could do. You could use this phone. Since this phone has just been recently added, you can use this phone to get a prompt. So what that would do is it would send a prompt to a device, in this case, that's logged into your account to confirm. So you'll need to be signed into your Google account on the phone to get the prompt. To turn off Google prompts on this device, sign out of your Google account on that device. That's why it's important to keep track of what devices you've signed into. That Google prompt is by default activated. So any device that you're signed into could be used to get access to your account if someone signed in. So to summarize, Google prompts become another part of an attack surface. If you're logged into a particular device, that device can provide access to your account if someone can get into the device. So be very careful about what devices you stay logged into. So get out of the two-step verification, come back into the account. And the most important thing to keep in mind here is that you now have two-step verification turned on and you have a recovery email address. And the thing to keep in mind about the recovery email address, again, that's an attack surface. So you want to make sure that the same level of security you provided to this account is provided to your backup email so that it's not any more vulnerable than your present account that you're trying to secure. So once you've added an account online, you'll want to add it to your phone also. So what you'll do is you'll come over here to Gmail and click Gmail. And then once you're in your account, you can go up here to the account icon, select the account icon, select add another account. We'll select Google. Then we'll enter the email address that we just created. Select next. We'll enter the account password. select next. And because this account has been secured with a hardware security key, it's prompting me for the key. But we have other second factor authentication methods. So we're going to say sign in without a key. And in this case, we've also secured this account with a Google Voice number. And that account that's on this Google Voice number is secured with a hardware security key. So we're going to use a code. Normally, I don't recommend using a phone because your cell phone can get hijacked. But a Google Voice number that is secured with a hardware security key is extremely hard to hijack. So we're going to use the verification code through the Google Voice phone number. So once you select that, then you'll enter in the code that gets sent to you and then select next. And now you get the welcome screen and you just click agree. And now you're in your account and you have your account on your Android phone. Now we'll go into the two-step verification methods that we have included on the account for protection. We'll drill into that on the phone. You see we have a hardware security key, we have Google Prompt sign-in, we have a Google Voice phone number, and we have backup security codes. So the hardware key will protect you physically from someone being able to access the account. Google Prompt is on a device. The Google Voice number is secured with a security key, and the backup codes, if all else fails, you can enter those to re-access the account. That pretty much has you covered no matter what happens. That concludes the video demonstration on how to set up an email account. Really interested in any one that has set up an account, any hurdles that you came across, any difficulties? Did you secure it with second factor authentication? Did you download backup codes? Are you concerned about your email being hacked? All those comments and feedback are wonderful and would really like to hear back from the viewers. If you have any questions or comments, please post them below. Please hit the subscribe button and have a great and wonderful automation day.